Hello, Lakers Nation. Guess what day it is again? That's right. It's game day. You've got the 4-2 Lakers taking on the 2-3 Memphis Grizzlies. I'm going to break down the matchup. But first, quick reminder, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Don't forget to turn on notifications so you get notified every time we put out a new video. And come join us over on the Flick app where we're talking Lakers basketball all day, every day. Just click the link in the description down below. Okay, Lakers versus Grizzlies. On paper, this is a mismatch, but in reality, yeah, it's a mismatch. There's no question. The Grizzlies right now, not only being more of kind of a mid-tier team, this isn't a title contending team, but they're also the walking wounded at the moment. This team is incredibly injured. They're missing Ja Morant, Jaren Jackson Jr., Justice Winslow, Grayson Allen even is dealing with an ankle injury. This is like if you called the Avengers and only Hawkeye showed up. That's basically what we're seeing here out of this Memphis Grizzlies squad. Their key pieces, for the most part, are not in action. So this is a major mismatch. But let me tell you this. You know, whenever I look at a matchup like this that we consider maybe a trap game, a game that a team might take a little bit lightly, it makes me think back to the Shaq and Kobe Lakers, who had this weird habit of losing games to the Charlotte Bobcats of all teams. You never know what's going to happen in the NBA. You have to show up on any given night, or you can get beat. So for the Lakers, there's still going to be some keys in order to get the job done and win this, even if they really should win this game. Now, the Grizzlies do a really nice job of spreading the ball around and spreading the minutes around. Both their starters and their bench is basically made up of role players. That's all that's left with so many guys being hurt. And so each player is getting 20 plus minutes per night. And so that gives you a little bit of a challenge because you're constantly facing fresh legs. You don't have anybody in particular on their team logging, say, 38 minutes a night, a star that they lean on. They don't have that. And so instead, they really spread things around well. Dylan Brooks is their biggest scoring threat. He can be goaded into some bad mistakes, taking some bad shots and things like that. So hopefully the Lakers defense will be able to impact him there. And then Jonas Valanciunas is legit in the post. There's no question he's a tremendous player, but I really like the matchup for Marc Gasol. This is a bigger, slower player in Valanciunas, which should give Gasol a chance to have an impact. And of course, let's not forget, he's playing his old team, the Memphis Grizzlies, so maybe there'll be a little bit something there. But Valanciunas is still a very good player that can give the Lakers some problems. But again, this is a game where I look for Marc Gasol to really shine. Now, while the Grizzlies do have a lot of players out, they are actually getting someone back that I really liked a lot in the draft a few years back. That's D'Anthony Melton from USC. He's a tremendous defender, and they really, really needed him because right now they have Tyus Jones as their starting point guard. And that's about it. They didn't really have another point guard on the roster, especially with Grayson Allen ailing. We have yet to determine whether or not Allen will actually play tonight. But they didn't have another ball handler. In fact, Brooks was having to be kind of their emergency initiator on the offensive end because most of their guys were simply out. So D'Anthony Melton comes back and does give them that, plus a tremendous defensive boost with him back as well. But let's be real again. The Lakers, they should dominate this matchup. In fact, there's a few questions, and one of the big ones is, should LeBron James even play? Look, LeBron, the Lakers are not without their own injuries. LeBron James has been dealing with an ankle injury. He has been on the injury report for the last few games, which isn't all that out of the ordinary. He was on the injury report pretty much all of last season, so that's not uncommon, and he tends to just play through it. But is this maybe an opportunity to rest LeBron James? Now, I think if they do play him, there's a pretty good chance that we can see some in-game load management. Again, if the Lakers show up and take care of business, if the Lakers can pull ahead to a big enough lead, you should be able to see LeBron James on the bench in the fourth quarter. But if they don't, you might have to play him. So do the Lakers simply decide, you know what, this is an opportunity, we're on the road, LeBron has been dinged up with that ankle injury, and we want to give him a chance to rest it, so let's sit him out of this one. I think if you're going to sit him out of any game right now, this would be a great opportunity to do it. And so I am curious to see whether or not he does go tonight. And then, of course, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope turned his ankle, looked pretty bad against the Spurs the other night, did not return to the game. But then afterwards, he said he was okay, which was a big relief. He's questionable for the game. I also wonder if he's got any kind of soreness. Do the Lakers elect to rest him as well, knowing that they're going up against an opponent that has a very, very depleted lineup? That might be a factor there as well for KCP. Other than that, the Lakers are basically healthy, still missing Alex Caruso. Caruso, though, who isn't traveling with the team right now due to the NBA's health and safety protocols. So those are certainly some big losses if all three of those guys are out. Caruso, we know. If you're missing Caruso, LeBron, and KCP, those are some big losses. But regardless, the Lakers should win this matchup. They're definitely the heavy favorites going in. And because of that, I would like the Lakers to really fix some things in this game. Particularly, I'd like to see Montrezl Harrell get going. And I said this in our last pregame video. I want to see a big performance out of Trez. I want to see him get going. It feels like it's been a few games now since we've really seen what we would consider a good performance out of him. Yes, he's been pretty solid on the boards, but I'd like to see a nice 20-10 game from Trez. I feel like he's got that in him. I don't think the Lakers have been utilizing him quite as much as I'd like to see in the pick and roll, particularly as the roll man. He doesn't get the ball back very often when he sets that screen. Maybe tonight is an opportunity to change that. So if we can get a nice performance out of Montrezl Harrell, that would be great. I'd also like to see the Lakers defense get back on track. In two games against the Spurs, we saw way too many drives to the basket where perimeter defenders were not containing their man. We saw a lot of open threes as well in the second game against the Spurs where guys weren't rotating very sharply. Those are things that need to get fixed as the season goes on. And I think this game against the Grizzlies is a great opportunity to kind of reset, call it a get right game if you want, but to get everything back on track on defense and make sure that they are communicating and getting to the right spots. And lastly, along those lines, as of right now, the Lakers rank near the very bottom of the NBA in steals and live ball turnovers to the Lakers. Well, they're golden. We know how deadly this team is in transition. And so I would like to see the Lakers really put some pressure on the Grizzlies, particularly without Ja Morant out there to handle the ball. I'd like to see them put some pressure on this Grizzlies squad, force some live ball turnovers, and get out and run. That is the way. That's how you do this. That's how you take this matchup and you go from being just a game that you win, that you fight through, you take care of business, and you get the W, to a game that you blow out, and then you can let your starters rest in the fourth quarter. You force turnovers, get out, get easy buckets in transition. It's something I think the Lakers need to push for a little bit more. And so that would be a key for me as well. Upping that steals number, getting those live ball turnovers, and then getting out and running. But let me know what you think. We're going to be talking Lakers basketball all day and during the game over on the Flick app. So use the link in the description down below. Also, don't forget, right after the game, we have our live post-game show. Come join us over on YouTube Live. We're streaming right there. You can come join us and I'll take your questions and comments. Plus, we'll be giving away prizes, so that's always a lot of fun. And then if you want to follow Lakers Nation across social media, you can find us at Lakers Nation on Twitter and Facebook, at Lakers Nation Official on Instagram. If you guys want to follow me, you can find me at Trevor_Lane on Twitter, at Trevor Lane NBA on Instagram and Facebook. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.